你好 ，This is our complete HSK 3 course with 300 words, sentences, as well as grammar explanation. It also should be useful as listening material. Okay, now let's get started.
阿姨，阿姨。
In a textbook or dictionary, it's translated to aunt.But to know how to use it correctly, just remember that is the way you call another woman who is your mom's age politely. It could be a stranger, but not the sister of your mom or dad.
阿姨，您找谁？
找小三儿。
啊？阿姨，您找谁？
阿姨。阿姨
，For example， 阿姨，这是您的吗？阿姨 ，Is this yours？ It could be a stranger。阿姨，这是您的吗 ？Now without 拼音。阿姨，这是您的吗 ？Okay， next one， 啊 ，It's a neutral tone because it's a function word. More specifically， it's a particle， like a 妈。Na, ba. It appears at the end of the sentence. It's hard to explain all the functions once. You have to learn it every time when you see it in a conversation. Here I'm going to show you one of the most important functions. It's to confirm the thing that another person said with a very certain tone. The most common examples are 对啊，是啊，好啊，对啊， Yes, you're totally right.是啊 ,yes, absolutely. 好啊 ,it's okay, for sure, when someone asks a favor or give you a suggestion. For example, A says, 我们去看电影吧。Let's go to see a movie. And B says, 好啊 means, okay, let's do it. So it shows your excitement. Compared with just 好,It's much more friendly. It's like, of course, yes, let's do it. Now without 拼音，我们去看电影吧。好啊。Next one, I. It means short. But remember, it only means vertically short. You can say a person is I, but you can't say a ruler is I. Just vertically. For example,他有点矮 He is a little short. 他有点矮 Now can you read it without 拼音他有点矮 Right, next one. 爱好 It means hobby. 爱好 Notice that here the character 好 has a fourth tone, a falling tone, like in the words 你好which is a third tone. You know, some characters have more than one pronunciation. 爱好 For example, 你有什么爱好? What hobbies do you have? 你有什么爱好? Now, without 拼音, only characters. 你有什么爱好? Next one, 安静 It means quiet.安静 For example, 请你安静一点 Please be quiet. 请你安静一点 Now only characters. 请你安静一点 Next one, 把 This is a measure word. It's a measure word for things with a handle.Because you see, here, there is a radical of a hand in this character. So it's something that we can hold with the hand. 把 For example, 一把伞 An umbrella. 一把刀 A knife. Both of them are with a handle. 一把椅子 A chair. Because, you know, most of the time, we hold the back of the chair with the hand. Example sentence.我买了一把椅子。I bought a chair. So this measure word sounds much better than 个. Now only characters. 我买了一把椅子。
By the way, we also have flashcards with which you can study along with these videos. You can practice and review anytime, anywhere. They're double-sized, one side with only characters, the other side with everything. And each card is coded by different color according to the part of speech of each word. They're really powerful tools. Make sure to check the link in the description box.
班, it means class, but here it refers to a group of people in a class, not the lesson. 班, for example, 我们班有30个人. There are 30 people in my class. 我们班有30个人. Now without a pinyin. 我们班有30个人. Next one. 班. Yes, it sounds exactly the same like the previous one, but with a different character and different meaning. It means move. To move from a house to another house. For example, 他搬家了. He moved. 他搬家了. Now only the characters, 他搬家了. Next one, 办法. It means way, approach, or a good idea to fix a problem. 办法. For example, 我有一个好办法. I have a good idea. But here it emphasizes a good idea to fix a problem, not just a creative idea. 我有一个好办法. Now only characters. 我有一个好办法. Next one, 办公室 means office. Do you remember that we learned 教室, classroom? Now it's 办公室. Both of them have 室. 室 means room. 办公室. For example, 这是我的办公室. This is my office. 这是我的办公室. Can you read without pinyin? 这是我的办公室. 帮忙. To help. 帮忙. For example, 你能不能来帮忙? Can you come to help? 你能不能来帮忙? Without pinyin, 你能不能来帮忙? Here a heads up, 帮忙 is an intransitive verb, so it can follow by other object. Don't say things like 我帮忙你, I help you. That is wrong, because the word 帮忙 already contains a verb and noun structure inside. We will explain this more in other grammar videos. Just remember, 帮忙 mostly appear at the end of the sentence. It's not followed by objects. Next one, 饱, it means full. When you have eaten enough food, you are full. So, I'm full is 我饱了. But in real life, it's more common to say 我吃饱了. 我吃饱了. Now, let's read just with the characters. 我饱了, 我吃饱了. Next one, 半, half, 半. For example, 现在3点半. Now it's 3 and a half. 现在3点半. Now without pinyin, 现在3点半. A heads up, if it's followed by a noun, don't forget to use a measure word. For example, 半个西瓜, half watermelon. Don't forget the measure word, 个, 半个西瓜. Next one, 包, it means bag or sack. 包, all kinds of bag that women use are called 包. Doesn't matter is backpack, or baguette, or flap, all it's called 包. For example, 你的包很漂亮. Your bag is very beautiful. 你的包很漂亮. Can you read it without pinyin? 你的包很漂亮. 北方 It means north or the northern part. Mostly it's used when you talk about things about China. Geographically, China can be divided into two parts by this line, and they are quite different in climate, topography, food, and culture, etc. So you will hear the term 北方, north, and 南方, south, a lot in China. For example, 你是北方人吗? Are you from the north? Here it refers to north of China. 你是北方人吗? Now let's read just the characters. 你是北方人吗? Next one, 北. This is a very important function word in Chinese. It's a preposition. It's used to indicate the passive voice. Let's see with the sentence. 我的作业被小狗吃了。My homework is eaten by a puppy. 我的作业被小狗吃了。Here is the sentence to start with the part that received the action, my homework, and it's got eaten by a puppy. 我的作业被小狗吃了。Now, without pinyin. 我的作业 被小狗吃了。Right, next one, 鼻子, nose, 鼻子. For example, 我喜欢你的鼻子。I like your nose. 我喜欢你的鼻子。Now, only characters, 我喜欢你的鼻子。Right, next one, 比较. It means comparatively. You use it when you are comparing with other things, but you also can use it as rather, fairly, or quite. For example, 今天比较冷. Today is fairly cold. Today is quite cold. 今天比较冷. Now, without pinyin. 今天比较冷. Next one, 比赛. It means match, competition, or contest. 比赛. For example, 今天晚上有足球比赛. A football game is going to be held tonight. There's a football game tonight. 今天晚上有足球比赛. Can you read without pinyin? 今天晚上有足球比赛. Next one, 笔记本. Traditionally, it means notebook, but nowadays it also refers to laptop. 笔记本. Let's see a sentence. 你看见我的笔记本了吗? Did you see my notebook? 你看见我的笔记本了吗? Now let's read just the characters. 你看见我的笔记本了吗? 你看见我的笔记本了吗? 必须. It means must. 必须. For example, 你明天必须来. You must come tomorrow. This could be something that you hear from your boss. 你明天必须来. Right? Now, without pinyin. 你明天必须来. Next one, 变化. It means to change. 变化. For example, 这里的天气变化很快. The weather changes very quickly here. One moment it's sunny and next minute it starts to rain. 这里的天气 变化很快. Now let's read just the characters. 这里的天气变化很快. Next one, 别人, other people, someone else. 别人. For example, 这是别人的,不是我的. This is of someone else, it's not mine. 这是别人的. 不是我的. Now without pinyin. 这是 别人的，不是我的。Right, next one, 冰箱。It means refrigerator. 冰箱。冰 means ice. 箱 is box. So literally, it's ice box, the refrigerator. For example, 我买了一个新冰箱。I bought a new refrigerator. 我买了一个新冰箱。Can you read it without pinyin? Try it. 我买了一个新冰箱。Great. Next one. 不但而且。Not only, but also. These two appears together like a fixed pattern. Not only, but also. For example, 她不但很漂亮，而且很聪明。She is not only very beautiful, but also very smart. 她不但很漂亮，而且很聪明。Right, now just the characters. 她不但很漂亮，而且很聪明。菜单 menu. 菜单，菜 means dish, 单 means list. So dish list is a menu. 菜单 For example, 服务员给我一个菜单。Waiter, give me a menu. 服务员给我一个菜单。Right, now without pinyin. 服务员给我一个菜单。Yes, when you speak very fast, the word 服务员 sounds like just 服务员. It's kind of like a reduction. 参加 It means to participate. 参加 For example,我参加了昨天的比赛。I participated in the match yesterday. 我参加了昨天的比赛。比赛 we already learned previous videos. It means game or match or competition. So let's read just the characters.
我参加了昨天的比赛。
Next one.草 It means grass.
草
For example, 牛吃草 The cows eat grass. And now just the characters.
牛吃草
Right, next one. 层 This is a major word and it's used for floors.
我的办公室在七层
My office is on the 7th floor.
我的办公室在七层。
Can you read it without pinyin?
我的办公室在七层。
Great. Next one.
差
It has many meanings, but the meaning we're seeing today is to fall short of.
我想买这个，但是差两块钱。
I want to buy this, but I'm short of 2 kuai. Like the thing costs 10 kuai, but you only have 8 kuai. So you're short of 2 kuai.
我想买这个，但是差两块钱。
This sentence is a little long, but let's try just read the characters. Come on, you can do it.
我想买这个，但是差两块钱。超市，超市。
Yes, you see the picture, it means supermarket. Here, 超 is short for 超级 super, and 市 is short for 市场。Market. So, 超市 supermarket. 好的 sentence.
我没去 超市。我没去超市。
I didn't go to the supermarket.
我没去超市。Okay, faster. 我没去超市。
Now, without pinyin, you know, in HSK 3 exams, there isn't pinyin, so you need to know the characters.
好, let's read it. 我没去超市。
Right, now you read it.
衬衫衬衫
Yes, it means shirt.
衬衫
Notice that here in both the character 衬 and 衫 it has a radical for clothes. So obviously, shirt is a piece of clothes. So it has this radical.
衬衫这件衬衫不是我的。这件衬衫不是我的。
This shirt is not mine. Notice that for shirt, we have the major word 件.
So, 这件衬衫不是我的。
好的 faster. 这件衬衫不是我的。Okay, a real life speed. 这件衬衫不是我的。Yes, we pronounce the in the final very light. 这件衬衫不是我的。Okay, now without pinyin. 这件衬衫不是我的。
Can you read it?
Perfect.
船船
It means boat or ship.
船
For example, Jack 和 Lucy.在船上 Jack 和 Lucy 在船上 Jack and Lucy are on the ship Jack 和 Lucy 在船上 Be careful with the pronunciation It's 船 boat or ship But if you say 船 it means bait So be careful with the pronunciation An and on Jack 和 Lucy在船上。
Okay, now without pinyin, Jack 和 Lucy 在船上。
This is a simple one. You can do it. Read it.
非常好。成绩，成绩。
It has many meanings. It could mean grade or score in a specific exam.But it also can mean performance or achievement in general. For example,
他的成绩很好。
他的成绩很好。Literally, it means his score is very good. It also means he got good academic performance in the school. So he does well in the school. He's a good student.
他的成绩很好。
Okay, faster, 他的成绩很好。You see, we pronounce the D very light. 他的成绩很好。Now, without pinyin to know the characters.
他的成绩很好。
Now, you read it. 好的，下一个，城市，
城市。
Yes, it means city.
城市。
上海是一个大城市。
上海是一个大城市。
上海 is a big city.
It sure is.
Okay, back to the sentence.上海是一个大城市。You know what? In real life speaking, sometimes we even skip the e. We just say 上海是个大城市。Real life speed, 上海是个大城市。Don't worry, with practice, you will get in that speed too.
Okay, now without pinyin, 上海是一个大城市。
好, now you read it.好的，非常好。好，下一个，迟到，
迟到。It means to be late. Here, 迟 means late. 到 means arrive. So, arrive late means to be late. 迟到。And it's a sentence. 我昨天迟到了。我昨天迟到了。I got late yesterday. Maybe for the school or the work. 我昨天迟到了。好 ,faster. 我昨天迟到了。Real life speed. 我昨天迟到了。我昨天迟到了。Now, without pinyin to learn the characters. 我昨天迟到了。好 ,you read it. 好的非常好。好下一个。除了。除了。It's a preposition. It means,Other than, 除了 It's better we see it with example sentence. 除了蓝色，你还喜欢什么颜色？ Okay, again, 除了蓝色，你还喜欢什么颜色？ It means, what colors do you like other than blue? Means, I know you like blue, but what more colors do you like beside blue? 除了蓝色你还喜欢什么颜色？好 ，faster。除了蓝色，你还喜欢什么颜色 ？Okay, now without pinyin。除了蓝色，你还喜欢什么颜色 ？Okay, now your turn. Don't skip it. You can do it. 春。It means spring. 春 For example, 谁不喜欢春天？谁不喜欢春天？ Who doesn't like spring? Yes, I do. 谁不喜欢春天？ Notice here that we say 春天 instead of 春 to mean spring. Here's the thing. In modern Chinese, we like the words made up with two characters.So we say 春天 instead of 春. So the character 春, we use it to make other words. For example, 春节 Spring Festival, the Chinese New Year. 春节 or 春卷, you know, spring roll, the famous Chinese food. 春卷. Okay, the sentence, 谁不喜欢春天?Who doesn't like spring? Faster, 谁不喜欢春天？好 ，now without 拼音，谁不喜欢春天 ？Right, now your turn. Perfect. 好的，下一个词典。词典 ，it means dictionary. 词典。好 ,sentence, 我买了一本词典。我买了一本词典。I bought a dictionary. Notice here we need the 本, like a major word for dictionary, and the same major word for book. 本。我买了一本词典。Faster, 我买了一本词典。好的 ,now without 拼音我买了一本词典。好的 ,you read it. Alright, 非常好。好下一个聪明。聪明 ,it means smart or clever. Here notice the tone of 明 is a second tone, but in your real life, most of the time, we pronounce it with a neutral tone. 聪明。聪明 ,alright, the sentence, 我的猫很聪明。我的猫很聪明。My cat is very clever. 哇、wow, it's a really smart cat. 好的 sentence, 我的猫很聪明。Faster, 我的猫很聪明。You see, we pronounce the very light. 我的猫很聪明。Right, without 拼音。我的猫很聪明。Now your turn. Great job. 公园，公园。It means park. Literally, 公 means public. 园 is garden. So a public garden is a park. 公园，公园。比如说，你要不要去公园？你要不要去公园？ It means, do you want to go to the park? So here, notice, 要不要 is another way to invite someone or give suggestion to someone. 要不要 want or not? Remember, 不 here, you just pronounce it very light. Just a slight, 要不要，要不要。So, 你要不要去公园？ Do you want to go to the park?Now, without 拼音, pay a lot of attention on the characters because later I'm going to ask you to read all the sentences of today without 拼音, just the characters, okay? 你要不要去公园？好，下一个故事，故事。So here, 是, we just pronounce it as a neutral tone. So it's 故事，故事。It means story.So literally, 故 means old, and 事 is things or stuff, so old stuff, like something happened, it's a story. 故事，比如说，天哪，这个故事是真的吗？好，再读一遍，天哪，这个故事是真的吗？ Oh my god, is this story real? So 天哪 is the Chinese way to say, oh my god.So, 天 literally means sky, heaven, or we can understand like universe. It's like God. 天哪 oh my God. 这个故事是真的吗？好 without 拼音。天 right, 天哪这个故事是真的吗？好的下一个刮风刮风。It means be windy.Remember, here is a verb. It's a verb, not adjective. So, 风 is wind. 刮 is a verb. 刮风 be windy. Let's see in the example sentence how to use it. 刮风的时候我的眼睛不舒服。好再读一遍。刮风的时候我的眼睛不舒服。好看看什么意思。My eyes feel uncomfortable when it's windy. But notice that in Chinese, the word order is a little different. So the condition goes first. 刮风的时候 when it's windy. 刮风的时候 Then comes the subject. 我的眼睛 my eyes. Then 不舒服 uncomfortable. Notice here, you don't need 是 Just 不舒服 uncomfortable. Immediately after the subject.So, 刮风的时候我的眼睛不舒服。When it's windy, my eyes uncomfortable. Only 汉字刮风的时候我的眼睛不舒服。好 right, 下一个关。关 okay, this one has many meanings. It could mean to turn off or to close. Don't worry, with this example sentence, you will remember both of the meanings very fast.
你睡觉的时候要关电脑、关手机、关灯、关门。
So here, 关电脑 turn off the computer. Then,关手机 turn off the cell phone. Then, 关灯 turn off the light. And, 关门 close the door. I will read it again.
你睡觉的时候要关电脑关手机关灯关门。 好，什么意思呢？ Look, you need to turn off the computer, the cell phone, the light, and close the door. So you see here, 要, we also can use it when you give suggestions to someone. So like, you need to do something, 要, okay? 你睡觉的时候, when you sleep, 要, you need to 关电脑, turn off the computer, 关手机, turn off the cell phone, 关灯, turn off the light, and 关门, close the door. You see, 关 has two meanings. It could be turn off or close. 再读一遍, I will read faster. 你睡觉的时候要关电脑。关手机，关灯，关门。好，那 without 拼音，你睡觉的时候要关电脑，关手机，关灯，关门。好的，下一个关系，关系 means relationship, but here.关 has nothing to do with to turn off or to close, just, and the word we just saw. It's very common that words have many meanings in Chinese. So here, 关 means to relate, and 系 it means to connect, 关系, relationship. And most of the time, we pronounce 系 with a neutral tone. So 关系, 关系. 好,看一个 sentence. 他们的关系没有以前那么好了。他们的关系没有以前那么好了。什么意思呢？ Their relationship is not as good as before. So this is a typical example when you need to compare two things. You use 没有, 没有, so not as good as. 他们的关系没有以前，以前 means before, 好 good, 那么好，那么 here means that, so 那么好 is that good, not that good as before, 那么好。Oh, 了 here is a function word to indicate a change, their relationship changed, now not as good as before, so it's changed. So let's read the sentence again.他们的关系没有以前那么好了。好，没有拼音。他们的关系没有以前那么好了。Good. 下一个，关心，关心 means to care for, to be interested. So we still have the same character here.关, it means to relate. You know, 心 means heart. So, like, I relate my heart with something means I care for it or I'm interested in that. 关心, 关心, 谁是最关心你的人? 谁是最关心你的人? Yes, it means who is the person who cares for you the most?You can leave the answer of this question in the comment section and share with us. But in Chinese, when you answer it, you just replace 谁, whom, with the person who cares for you the most. 好的, only 汉字。谁是最关心你的人? 好的,下一个。关于, still this character.关于 It's a proposition. It means about or regarding. Let's see how to use it.
关于这个问题，我不想再说了。关于这个问题，我不想再说了。
I don't want to talk anymore about this question. But you see, in Chinese, the order is a little different. We put
关于这个问题。
About this question goes first. Then comes the main part.
我不想再说了。
I don't want to talk anymore. So here, 再 means again or more. Actually, you know, 再见,
Goodbye. Literally, it means see you again. 再见。Okay, let's read it again.
关于这个问题，我不想再说了。
好的 ，only 汉字。
关于这个问题，我不想再说了。
好的，下一个。
国家，国家
，it means country or nation. Literally, 国 means country, 家 means family. So here shows the concept of a country for Chinese people is like a big family.
国家
，example sentence:
不同的国家有不同的文化。不同的国家有不同的文化。
Different countries have different cultures. This sentence structure is very simple. Let's read again.
不同的国家有不同的文化。
不同 no same, so it means different. Without 拼音，
不同的国家有不同的文化。
过过 It's a verb. It means to spend, to pass. Okay, let's see how to use it in example sentence.
你今年打算怎么过圣诞节?
By the way, 圣诞节 means Christmas. 好, let's read again.
你今年打算怎么过圣诞节?
How do you plan to spend the Christmas this year?You see, in Chinese, the word order in a question is the same as the word order in a statement. So literally, you this year plan how to spend Christmas.
你今年打算怎么过圣诞节?
Like where or with whom? 好的 ,only 汉字。
你今年打算怎么过圣诞节，
最后一个 last one，
过去，过去
is a noun. It means past. Remember, 过 means past. 去 already gone.
过去 past.
比如说，
过去的事情我还记得很清楚。
Again,
过去的事情。我还记得很清楚。
什么意思呢? I still remember the things in the past clearly. But in Chinese, the word order is different. This is a typical example, so pay a lot of attention. In this sentence, there are two subjects. The subject of the whole sentence is this part.
过去的事情
The thing in the past.
过去的事情
Okay, this is the subject of the whole sentence.But it immediately followed by another subject.
我
I
我还记得很清楚
I still remember 记得 is remember
很清楚
very clearly. Okay, let's read again.
过去的事情我还记得很清楚
好的 only 汉字
过去的事情我还记得很清楚。
还是，还是。It's a conjunction, it means or, but normally we use in a question where you need to make a choice. 比如说，
你爱我还是爱他
？Do you love me or her?
你爱我还是爱他
See, this side is option A, 我 and this side is option B. So you need to choose one of them.
你爱我还是爱他
好 now without 拼音 let's try it.
你爱我还是爱他
好下一个
害怕害怕
You see this little man? It means to be afraid, to be scared.
害怕。比如说，我一点儿也不害怕考试。
I'm not afraid of the exam at all.
我一点儿也不害怕考试。
Attention to the words ordered here.
The main part of the sentence is 我 then jump to here. 不害怕考试。
I'm not afraid of the exam.
But to say not at all, we put 一点儿也一点儿 a little, not even a little. 我一点儿也不害怕考试。
Okay, without pinyin,
我一点儿也不害怕考试。好，下一个，黑板 right, is blackboard. 黑 is black, 板 is board. 黑板 blackboard. Example sentence, 老师把我的名字写在了黑板上。
It's a little long, let's read again.
老师把我的名字写在了黑板上。
The teacher wrote my name on the blackboard. Uh-oh, are you in trouble? Here's a very important HSK3 grammar. 把 is a preposition, appears before the object that it receives action. So here the object is 我的名字。My name,
老师把我的名字写在了黑板上。好的 ，without 拼音，老师把我的名字写在了黑板上。
Great，
下一个，后来
later afterwards，
比如说，他们过去。是朋友，后来是同事。
They were friends in the past and later become co-workers.
过去 is in the past, 后来 means later. 他们过去是朋友，后来是同事。好 ，without 拼音，他们过去是朋友，后来。是同事。好，下一个，护照
yes, passport,
护照。你把我的护照放在哪里了？
Where did you put my passport?
You see, here again is 把 the preposition comes before the object that receives action. So here the object is my passport, 我的护照。你把我的护照放在哪里了？
Without 拼音，
你把我的护照放在哪里了？好，下一个，花
yes, flowers.
比如说，你跟这些花一样漂亮。
You are as beautiful as these flowers.
Boys, take notes, learn this line.
Attention with the word order.
你跟这些花
comes first.
So you and these flowers, then 一样漂亮
same beautiful.
你跟这些花一样漂亮
Without 拼音，
你跟这些花一样漂亮。
Next one,
花
Yes, you're right. Exactly the same character, but it has another meaning. Now it's a verb. It means to spend.
花，比如说，很多人不愿意花钱看电影。
A lot of people are not willing to spend money to see movies. They prefer free resources.
很多人不愿意花钱看电影
，without 拼音，
很多人不愿意花钱看电影。好的，下一个，话
，a falling tone，
话，
Attention, it can be a verb to mean to draw, to paint, but also can be the noun, the drawing, the painting. Don't worry, you will learn both of the meaning in this example sentence.
这是你画的画吗？真漂亮。
Did you paint these paintings? They're so beautiful. So here, look where the pointer is. This 画 is the noun, means the painting. And the part to modify is 你画的 that you paint. So here, 画 is a verb.
这是你画的画吗？真漂亮。
So beautiful. Here's the common structure to give compliment.
这是你画的画吗？真漂亮。
Without 拼音，
这是你画的画吗？真漂亮。
好，下一个，坏，坏 means broken, ruined.
坏，
比如说，电梯怎么又坏了 ？Why the elevator broken again? 怎么 is another way to say why rather than 为什么。When you are surprised or shocked,
电梯怎么又坏了？
又 again without 拼音，
电梯怎么又坏了？
好，最后一个，欢迎，欢迎 it means welcome. Literally, 欢 means happy, and 迎 it means when you receive someone when he arrives. So 欢迎 receive someone happily. So welcome.比如说，欢迎你来我家 ，Welcome to my home.
欢迎你来我家
，without 拼音，
欢迎你来我家。
还，还 means to return. We learned this character before with another pronunciation 还 but here is another pronunciation 还。To return.
比如说你把我的猫还给我。
Give me back my cat. So here, 把 we use a lot when we give orders. So literally, you 把 my cat return to me.
你把我的猫还给我。
Without characters, can you try to read it?
对。你把我的猫还给我。
Real life speed.
你把我的猫还给我。
You can barely hear the d.
你把我的猫还给我。
好，下一个，环境。环境 means environment. 比如说，这里的环境越来越好了。The environment here is getting better and better.So, 越来越 is a fixed structure to say more and more.
这里的环境越来越好了。
好 without 拼音 read it.
这
非常好。这里的环境越来越好了。Faster. 这里的环境越来越好了。下一个换。换 it means to change, to substitute. 比如说，
我听说他又换女朋友了。
I heard that he changed girlfriends again. So here, 又 again, and normally we use it for something happened already.
我听说他又换女朋友了。
好 ，without 拼音 ，read it please.
我。
Right. 我听说他又换女朋友了。Faster. 我听说他又换女朋友了。下一个，黄河。黄河。Yellow River is the second largest river in China. 比如说，你知道黄河为什么叫黄河吗？Do you know why the Yellow River is called Yellow River? If you know it, please leave your answer in the comment section.
你知道黄河为什么叫黄河吗？
好，without 拼音，let's read it。你对，你知道黄河为什么叫黄河吗？Real life speed，你知道黄河为什么叫黄河吗？好，下一个回答，回答 ，it means to answer。You see here, both 回 and 答 have the radical of mouth here and here. 比如说，你先回答我，我再告诉你。You answer me first, and then I will tell you. So here, 先 and 再 is kind of like a fixed structure to say something first and then another thing. 你先回答我。我再告诉你。好，without 拼音，read it。你，right，你先回答我，我再告诉你。Real life state，你先回答我，我再告诉你。会议，会议，it means meeting or conference。比如说，这个会议对我来说很重要。This meeting is very important to me. So here, pay attention to 对我来说 It means for me. We use a lot in real life to say for me. It appears right after the subject. 好，这个会议对我来说很重要。对，好 ，only characters. Let's read it. 这嗯，很好。这个会议对我来说很重要。Real life speed， 这个会议对我来说很重要。好，下一个，或者，或者 is a conjunction means or。比如说，你可以给我打电话或者发邮件。You can call me or email me. So you see.或者 we use it when we give more than one option. 比如你可以给我打电话或者发邮件。好 ，now only characters read it. 你嗯，非常好。你可以给我打电话或者发邮件。好，下一个几乎。几乎 ，it means almost。比如说，五年了，你几乎没变化。It's been 5 years, you almost haven't changed。五年了，你几乎没变化。好 ，without 拼音 ，can you read it？ 五 ，right， 五年了。你几乎没变化 ，faster。五年了，你几乎没变化。好，下一个机会，机会 it means opportunity。比如说 ，this is a famous saying， 机会是给准备好的人 ，opportunity is for those who are prepared。Remember， 准备 is prepare and 准备好。Is prepared or ready. People quote this saying a lot. 机会是给准备好的人。好 ，without 拼音，机，对，机会是给准备好的人。好，下一个，急，急 means extremely.A common way to use it is in the final of the sentence. 比如说，他对这个礼物满意极了。She is very satisfied with this gift. Extremely satisfied is even more than 很 or 非常。So you see, literally, she with this gift satisfied extremely. 他对这个礼物满意极了。好 ，without 拼音 ，can you read it？ 他
嗯，很好。他对这个礼物满意极了。
记得，记得。It means to remember. 比如说，我记得他跟我一样高。
I remember he and I are of the same height.
我记得他跟我一样高。
好 ,now without pinyin, can you read it?
我对我记得他跟我一样高。
Real life speed,
我记得他跟我一样高。好下一个季节。季节 ,it means season. 比如说春天是一年中最美的季节。
Spring is the most beautiful season of the year. But notice that in Chinese, to say of the year is not at the end of the sentence. Instead, here, 一年中 is the first part of the modifier of 季节.
Remember in Chinese, the time range normally is not at the end of the sentence. 春天是一年中最美的季节。好 ,without 拼音 ,read it please. 春好的春天是一年中最美的季节。
Real life speed.
春天是一年中最美的季节。好下一个检查。检查 ,it means to check, to examine, to test. 比如说我带你去医院检查一下吧。
Let me take you to the hospital to have a test.
So you see, it's very common we put 一下 after the verb when we make a proposal or suggestion. To emphasize, it's just a short and quick action. 我带你去医院检查一下吧。好 ,without 拼音 ,read it please. 我对我带你去医院检查一下吧。
Real life speed.
我带你去医院检查一下吧。下一个简单。简单 ,it means simple. 比如说我想过一种简单的生活。
I want to live a simple life. I think this is a wish of a lot of people.
我想过一种简单的生活。好 ,only characters, let's read it. 我对我想过一种简单的生活。
Faster,
我想过一种简单的生活。下一个见面。见面。So literally, 见 is see, 面 is face. To see face. So when we use 见面 to mean meet, it got to be face to face. 比如说他们一见面就吵架。
They quarrel and so on and they meet.
They don't get along well, they fight a lot. So here we got a fixed structure, 一 something 就 to mean the second action happens immediately when the first action takes place. So here we got the action 见面 is the first action meet, and the second action is quarrel, 吵架. So they quarrel and so on and they meet. 他们一见面就吵架。好 ,only characters, please read it. 他对他们一见面就吵架。
Faster,
他们一见面就吵架。好下一个健康。健康 ,it means healthy or health. 比如说什么都没有健康重要。
Nothing is as important as health.
So 什么都 is anything. But 什么都没 or 什么都不 means nothing. 什么都没有健康重要。
Nothing is as important as health. 好, without 拼音, please read it.
沈,
对, 什么都没有健康重要。
Real life speed.
什么都没有健康重要。
讲,
讲, it means to explain. You see, here, this part is a radical of speech. And 讲, when it means to explain, normally it's about a professional or academic topic.
比如说, 我不懂,你给我讲讲吧。
I don't understand. Can you explain it for me? Notice here, we repeat 讲 to 讲讲. It's very common to repeat the verb when we ask a favor or give suggestions to make an easy and casual intonation.
我不懂,你给我讲讲吧。
好, now without 拼音, read it.
我不懂,你给我讲讲吧。
Real life speed.
我不懂,你给我讲讲吧。
好, 下一个,
教,
教, it means to teach. Remember when we learned classroom, the pronunciation was 教, the first tone, but here when it's a verb, it's the first tone,
教,
教.
比如说, 除了教我汉语, 他还教我做中国菜。
Besides teaching me Chinese, he also teaches me to cook Chinese dishes.
除了教我汉语, 他还教我做中国菜。
好, only characters, read it.
除了,
非常好, 除了教我汉语, 他还教我做中国菜。 Real life speed. 除了教我汉语, 他还教我做中国菜。 好, 下一个,
角,
角 is a unit of money in China. It's 10% of yuan.
比如说, 五角钱就是五毛钱。
5角 is the same as 5毛. The thing is, there are two ways to say it. 角 is a formal way, and 毛 is an informal way. But they're the same. So 就是 here means the same as or equals to. So 五角钱就是五毛钱. 好, can you read it without 拼音?
五,
非常好, 五角钱就是五毛钱. 好, faster, 五角钱就是五毛钱. 好, 下一个,
角,
角, it means foot. Here, this radical normally is about the body part.
脚,
比如说, 他的左脚比右脚大一点。 His left foot is a little bigger than right foot.
他的左脚比右脚大一点。
好, only characters, read it please.
他,
嗯, 很好, 他的左脚比右脚大一点, faster, 他的左脚比右脚大一点,
接,
接, it means to meet someone, to pick up someone, to receive someone when he arrives from another place.
比如说, 你到了吗? 我马上去接你,
have you arrived? I will go and pick you up right now.
你到了吗?
我马上去接你。 好, without 拼音, can you read it?
你,
好, 非常好,
你到了吗?
我马上去接你。 Real life speed,
你到了吗? 我马上去接你。
好, 下一个,
街道,
街道 means street. 比如说, 这条街道总是干干净净的。 This street is always clean. So here, 条 is a major word for street. It's a major word normally for something long. And here, 干干净净 clean. You know, the original word is 干净 but we repeat each character and make it 干干净净 So we do this to the adjective if we want to describe something vividly and show our affection.
这条街道总是干干净净的。
好 now only characters, read it please.
这
好的这条街道总是干干净净的。
Real life speed, 这条街道总是干干净净的。
下一个节目节目 It means program. 比如说这个电视节目越来越无聊了。
This TV program is getting more and more boring.
So here, 越来越 is a fixed structure to say more and more. And here, 了 it indicates a changed situation. So this program was interesting before, but now it's getting boring. So
这个电视节目越来越无聊了。
好 ,now only characters.
这
这个电视节目越来越无聊了。
Real life state. 这个电视节目越来越无聊了。
好下一个节日。节日。It means festival.比如说你知道哪些中国节日
Which Chinese festivals do you know?
This is also a question for you. You can leave your answer in the comment section. Share with us.
你知道哪些中国节日
好 only characters read it please.
你
Right.你知道哪些中国节日
Faster,
你知道哪些中国节日好下一个结婚结婚
To marry, to get married.
I have another video talking about love and relationship words. Make sure to check it out.
比如说有的人觉得跟谁结婚都一样
Some people thinkthat it doesn't make any difference whom you marry. Okay, it's a little negative, but yes, some people think like this. What do you think?
This part, 跟谁结婚都一样,
literally means with whom marry all the same.
有的人觉得跟谁结婚都一样。
好, only characters, can you read it?
有有的人觉得跟谁结婚都一样。
好 ,real life speed. 有的人觉得跟谁结婚都一样。好下一个结束。结束。It means to end, to finish.
比如说这个故事结束的太突然了。
This story ends too suddenly.So here we use a function word 的 when we want to make a comment. So your comment is, it's too sudden. So
这个故事结束的太突然了。
好 only characters, let's read it.
这
Right. 这个故事结束的太突然了。
Faster.
这个故事结束的太突然了。好下一个解决。解决。It means to solve
a problem.
比如说谢谢你帮我解决了这个问题。
Thank you for helping me solve this problem. A very useful sentence for real life.
谢谢你帮我解决了这个问题。好 only characters, let's read it.谢谢 Right 谢谢你帮我解决了这个问题
Real life speed
谢谢你帮我解决了这个问题。好，下一个，借，借 ，it means to borrow or to lend. Okay, that's a little confusing. How do you know you mean to borrow or to lend? Well, in real life, most of the time, we can understand it by the context. But if you want to make it very clear without misunderstanding, pay attention to this example sentence.
他跟我借了钱，又借给了别人。
He borrowed money from me, then lent it to someone else. So you see here, to say borrow from me, we say 跟我借。And to say lend to someone, we say 借给 someone.
他跟我借了钱，又借给了别人。
好的 ,only characters, please read it.
他
对，他跟我借了钱，又借给了别人。Real life state, 他跟我借了钱，又借给了别人。好，下一个，经常，经常 means often. 比如说，他经常带女儿去上班。
She often takes her daughter to work.
他经常带女儿去上班。好 ,only characters, read it please.
他
,right, 他经常带女儿去上班。好 ,faster, 他经常带女儿去上班。好下一个经过。经过 means to pass by. 比如说我经过公园的时候进去走了一会儿。
I entered and walked for a while when I passed by the park.
Just remember the word order, the part when I passed by the park in Chinese goes in the beginning instead of in the end.
我经过公园的时候进去走了一会儿。
Okay, without pinyin, read it please.
我
好的。我经过公园的时候进去走了一会儿。Real life speed. 我经过公园的时候进去走了一会儿。
经理。经理。
It means manager. 比如说你们经理是男的还是女的。
Is your manager a man or woman?
Since your manager is the manager of a lot of people,So here we use 你们 instead of 你。
你们经理是男的还是女的？
好 ，without 拼音 ，can you read it？
你们对，你们经理是男的还是女的
？Real life speed， 你们经理是男的还是女的？好，下一个酒，酒。It means for a long time. 比如说你们结婚多久了
?How long have you been married?
So 多久 is how long. Of course, you also can say 多长时间 It's the same.
你们结婚多久了
好 without 拼音 read it please.
你们
对你们结婚多久了
Real life speed, 你们结婚多久了？
好，下一个旧，旧 ，it means old, used or worn. 比如说，你的旧电脑被他卖了。
Your old computer was sold by him.
So here is how we do a passive sentence. The most important thing is 被。It's a preposition with which we make a passive sentence. So the subject of the sentence, 你的旧电脑 your computer, and then follows by the preposition 被, and then follows by the doer of the action, him, and finally it comes the verb, sell. So literally is your old computer by him sold.
你的旧电脑被他卖了。
好 ,only characters, read it please.
你的对你的旧电脑被他卖了。
Real life speed, 你的旧电脑被他卖了。
好下一个句子。句子
,it means a sentence.
比如说这个句子又长又难。
This sentence is long and difficult.
So here, 又 something is a fixed structure. So we can put two adjectives together to emphasize it. So this sentence is not only long, but also difficult.
这个句子又长又难。
好 only characters, read it please.这个对这个句子又长又难。好下一个决定。决定
,it means to decide.
比如说你决定好买哪个了吗
?Have you decided which one to buy?
Attention here, 决定 is to decide, and 决定好is decided. So, 好 is a complement, the result of 决定。
你决定好买哪个了吗
?Only characters, read it please.
你
Right. 你决定好买哪个了吗
?Actually, in spoken language, most of the time, the pronunciation of 哪 became 哪。
So it's, 你决定好买哪个了吗？
好，下一个可爱，可爱
，lovely, adorable, cute。比如说，这把伞很可爱，就是有点贵。
This umbrella is very cute, just a little expensive.
So attention here, this is how you can complain politely, subtly,
without saying but,
但是。Instead, here we say 就是 It's a subtle turning. And to make it more polite, we also use 有点 a little bit. So 就是有点贵 just a little expensive.
这把伞很可爱就是有点贵
把 is a major word for umbrella, which has a handle that you can hold.
好 without 拼音 let's read it.
这对这把伞很可爱就是有点贵。下一个渴
it means thirsty. You see, here's the radical of water, three drops of water.
渴比如说给我一杯水我渴死了。
Please give me a cup of water. I'm dying for thirst. But in Chinese, to say dying for thirst is
渴死
thirst to death.
给我一杯水，我渴死了。
好 ，only characters, read it please.
给我，对，给我一杯水，我渴死了。好，下一个课。课
it means quarter. We used it to say time.
比如说都十点一刻了你怎么还不睡
It's already 10:15. Why are you still not sleeping?
Attention here, the function word 都 is to indicate the number is big. So it's already 10:15.
都十点一刻了你怎么还不睡
好 ,without 拼音 ,let's read it. 都对都十点一刻了你怎么还不睡好下一个客人客人
,it means customer or guest.
比如说我想不起来
这位客人的名字了。I can't recall the name of this customer. So to say don't remember or can't recall, we say 想不起来。This is a typical grammar structure in Chinese. It's a verb and the complement. So the verb 想 to think, and the complement 不起来. So you try to think about it, but it just doesn't come to your mind. 想不起来。好，我想不起来这位客人的名字了。Without 拼音，我。Right, 我想不起来这位客人的名字了。好，下一个空调，空调 means air conditioner. 空 is short for 空气 air. 调 is short for 调节 adjust. So air conditioner is something to adjust the temperature of the air. 比如说，你睡觉前别忘了。关空调。Don't forget to turn off the air conditioner before you sleep. 你睡觉前别忘了关空调。好 ,just characters, read it please. 你 Right, 你睡觉前别忘了关空调。口口Mouth or mouthful. But in spoken language, we don't use this to say mouth. Instead, we say 嘴巴. So this word 口, we mostly use it to form a new word with another character. For example, 口红 lipstick, or 口水 saliva. Also, it's a major word, means mouthful. 比如说，医生说你一口酒都不能喝。The doctor said that you can't drink even one drop of alcohol, not even a sip. So here is a fixed structure, 一都不, to negate something with a strong tone. So not only you can't drink, you can't even take a sip, not at all. 医生说你一口酒都不能喝。Okay, now without pinyin, can you read it please? 医生Right, 医生说你一口酒都不能喝。Real life speed, 医生说你一口酒都不能喝。下一个，哭，哭 ，it means cry. 比如说，他说着说着哭了起来。He started crying when he was talking. This sentence looks short, but it has very advanced grammar point here.First, 哭了起来 start to cry. So this structure is the verb 哭 then the complement 了起来 So 起来 literally means rise up. So it's like the action of crying rised up. So he started crying. And here, 说着说着 we use the function word 遮 twice.说着说着 to indicate he was talking, and then he started to cry. So this is how we say the second action start when the first action was going on. So here the first action is he's talking, then the second action is he start crying. 他说着说着哭了起来。Okay, only characters, let's read it. 他Right, 他说着说着哭了起来。Faster, 他说着说着哭了起来。下一个裤子，裤子 ，it means pants. 比如说，我已经有两条这样的裤子了。I already have two pairs of pants like this. 我已经有两条这样的裤子了。Okay, now your turn. 我 对,
我已经有两条这样的裤子了。
Faster， 我已经有两条这样的裤子了。
好，下一个，筷子，筷子
，Yes， chopsticks。
比如说，我学会用筷子了。
I have learned to use chopsticks. It means successfully learned something. So here, 会 is a complement of 学. So you learned and you successfully got the skill.
我学会用筷子了。
好 ，only characters.
我
，right。
Faster， 我学会用筷子了。好，下一个蓝，蓝
，it means blue。
比如说，蓝蓝的天上有几片白白的云。
There are some white clouds in the blue sky. You see here, we repeat 蓝蓝
，blue， and we repeat 白白 ，white。
So we repeat the adjectives sometimes when we want to describe something vividly, especially if we love it.
蓝蓝的天上有几片白白的云。
Okay, now without 拼音, read it please.
蓝蓝
Right.
蓝蓝的天上有几片白白的云。
Real life speed.
蓝蓝的天上有几片白白的云。老，老
，right, it means old.
比如说，我今天接到了一个老朋友的电话。
I got a call from an old friend today. So old friend,
老朋友。
And to say receive a call, we use the verb 接。We saw this in the previous chapter.接 to receive something.
我今天接到了一个老朋友的电话。
Okay, only characters, let's read it.
我
Right.
我今天接到了一个老朋友的电话。
Faster. 我今天接到了一个老朋友的电话。
下一个离开。离开
，it means to leave, to part with. This is one of the separable word in Chinese.
比如说，你别走，我离不开你。
You see, we insert something between them. This sentence means, don't go, I can't live without you. So here we insert 不 between 离 and 开 means can't separate.I can't separate with you.
你别走，我离不开你。
Okay, only characters, let's read it.
你
Okay, 你别走，我离不开你。Real life speed, 你别走，我离不开你。
好，下一个，礼物，礼物
It means gift or present.
比如说，他把礼物拿出来放在桌子上。
He took out the gift and put it on the table. Here we see the preposition 把 again. It's very commonly used to indicate that an action is imposed upon a certain people or things to make them move or change. So here he took out the gift and he put it on the table. So they moved and the location changed.
他把礼物拿出来放在桌子上。
Okay, only characters, read it please.
他
对，他把礼物拿出来放在桌子上。
Faster，
他把礼物拿出来放在桌子上。好，下一个历史，
历史
，history。
比如说，我以前最喜欢的课就是历史课。
My favorite subject previously was history. Here, the function word 就 is not necessary, but you can use it if you want to emphasize a history class.
好，我以前最喜欢的课就是历史课。
好，without pinyin, read it, please.
我以前最喜欢的课就是历史课。
Faster.
我以前最喜欢的课就是历史课。
好，下一个，脸。脸，right, means face.
比如说，他的脸看上去比照片更漂亮。
Her face looks even more beautiful than the photo. So to say, it looks is
看上去
looks.
她的脸看上去比照片更漂亮。
好 ，your turn, please.
她的，她的脸看上去比照片更漂亮。
Okay, real life speed.
她的脸看上去比照片更漂亮。
打扫，打扫。You see, both of the characters have the radical of hand. So it's action related with hand. It means do cleaning. 比如说，我今天要打扫房间。I'm going to clean my room today.
我今天要打扫房间。
Okay, now without characters, can you try to read it?
我，对，我今天要打扫房间。
Real life speed. 我今天要打扫房间。
下一个，打算，打算。
It means plan. It could be a verb or a noun.
比如说，明天你打算做什么？
What do you plan to do tomorrow?
明天你打算做什么？
Literally, tomorrow you plan to what?
明天你打算做什么？
Okay.Now, without pinyin, please read it.
明天，
对，明天你打算做什么？ Faster, 明天你打算做什么？ Okay, another example.
你明天有什么打算？
What plan do you have tomorrow?So it's another way to say the sentence, but here, 打算 it's a noun.
你明天有什么打算?
You tomorrow have what plan?
你明天有什么打算?
All right, now only characters, please read it.
你
对，你明天有什么打算? Real life speed, 你明天有什么打算?
下一个，带，带
means to take or to bring. That's the same in Chinese. It just means you have something along with you.
带，
比如说，我明天带你去公园。I will take you to the park tomorrow.
我明天带你去公园。
I tomorrow take you go park.
我明天带你去公园。
All right, only characters, please read it.
我 我明天带你去公园。Faster, 我明天带你去公园。Another example, 你帮我带一瓶水吧。Bring me a bottle of water. So here, 带 means bring. 你帮我带一瓶水吧。Now only characters, please try to read it. 你你帮我带一瓶水吧。Faster, 你帮我带一瓶水吧。下一个，担心，担心。It means to worry. 比如说，别担心。Don't worry. 别担心。Alright, only characters.Right, 别担心。好，下一个，蛋糕，蛋糕。It means cake. 比如说，生日蛋糕，生日蛋糕。It's birthday cake. Another example, 我会做蛋糕。I know how to make cakes.我会做蛋糕。Only characters, can you read it? 我，对，我会做蛋糕。Right. Next one. 当然，当然。It means of course. 比如说 this conversation. A said, 你爱我吗？ Do you love me?And B answers, 当然了。Of course. Let's read it again. 你爱我吗？当然了。All right, only characters. 你爱我吗？当然了。Let's read it faster. 你爱我吗？当然了。下一个的 is a particle to describe an action. 比如说他高兴地走了。He lived happily. 他高兴地走了。So, 走 means leave. 走了 left. So, how he left? Well, he left happily. So, we use the particle 的 to connect.高兴 happily, and the verb, leave, okay? 他高兴地走了。Now only characters, let's read it. 他高兴地走了。Faster, 他高兴地走了。下一个，灯，灯。It means light or lamp.比如说，台灯，台灯 is this kind of lamp for your desk. And 路灯，路灯 means street light. 路 means street. 路灯。Another one, 红绿灯，红绿灯 traffic light. 红 is red.绿 is green, so 红绿灯 traffic light. Next one, 地方，地方 means place. 比如说，我不喜欢这个地方。I don't like this place. 我不喜欢这个地方。All right.Not only characters, let's read it. 我不喜欢这个地方。Faster, 我不喜欢这个地方。Okay, next one. 地铁，地铁 means subway. 比如说 我坐地铁上班。
I take the subway to work.
我坐地铁上班。
All right. Now only characters. Let's read it.
我坐地铁上班。
Faster. 我坐地铁上班。
地图，地图
means map.
比如说，我有一张北京地图。
I have a map of 北京。
我有一张北京地图。
Okay, only characters. Let's read it.
我有一张北京地图。
Faster. 我有一张北京地图。
下一个，电梯。电梯
means elevator.
比如说，我们这儿没有电梯。
We don't have elevator here.
我们这儿没有电梯。
Without 拼音，
我们这儿没有电梯。
Faster, 我们这儿没有电梯。
下一个，电子邮件。电子邮件
，email。
比如说，你可以给我发电子邮件。
You can send me an email.
你可以给我发电子邮件。
Okay, now only characters. Let's read it.
你可以给我发电子邮件。
Faster. 你可以给我发电子邮件。
Okay, 下一个，东。东
means east.
比如说，这是我们学校的东门。
This is the east gate of our school.
这是我们学校的东门。
All right, now only characters. Let's read it.
这是我们学校的东门。
Faster, 这是我们学校的东门。
下一个，东。东
，it means winter. Yes, it sounds exactly like the previous one, but different character, different meaning.
比如说，冬天来了。
Winter is coming.
冬天来了。
All right, only characters.
冬天来了。
Faster, 冬天来了。
下一个，动物。动物
means animal.
比如说，你喜欢什么动物？
What animals do you like?
你喜欢什么动物？
Right, now without 拼音，
你喜欢什么动物？
Right. Faster, 你喜欢什么动物？
下一个，短。短
，it means short.
比如说，你的裙子太短了。
Your skirt is too short.
你的裙子太短了。
Okay, now only characters. Let's read it.
你的裙子太短了。
Faster, 你的裙子太短了。
下一个，断。 段 is a measure word. It's used for sections or periods. 比如说，这段时间我很忙。I'm very busy in these days. 这段时间我很忙。All right, now only characters. 这段时间我很忙。Right, faster. 这段时间我很忙。下一个，锻炼。锻炼 ，it means do physical exercise. 比如说，我每天都锻炼。I do exercise every day. 我每天都锻炼。Only characters. 我每天都锻炼。Faster.我每天都锻炼。下一个，多么，多么 ，it means very or to a great extent。比如说，明天多么冷，我都要去游泳。I will go to swim tomorrow, no matter how cold it is。明天。多么冷，我都要去游泳。Without 拼音 ，let's read it. 明天多么冷，我都要去游泳。Faster. 明天多么冷，我都要去游泳。饿，饿 ，it means hungry. 比如说。我快饿死了。I'm starving. Very useful sentence in daily life. 我快饿死了。死 means die. 我快饿死了。Only characters. 我快饿死了。我快饿死了。Faster. 我快饿死了。下一个，耳朵。耳朵 ，it means ear。比如说，你的耳朵怎么这么红 ？Why is your ear so red？ 你的耳朵怎么这么红 ？Only characters。你的耳朵怎么这么？红 ，faster， 你的耳朵怎么这么红？下一个，发，发 ，means to send a photo, to send an email, to send a message。比如说，他给我发了一张照片。She sent me a photo。他给我发了一张照片。Literally, she to me sent a piece of photo. 她给我发了一张照片。Only characters. 她给我发了一张照片。Faster.他给我发了一张照片。下一个，发烧。发烧 ，it means to have fever。比如说，天哪，你发烧了。Oh my God, you have fever。天哪，你发烧了。Right, only characters。天哪。你发烧了 ，faster！ 天哪，你发烧了。下一个，发现，发现 ，to discover。比如说，我发现 这里的东西更便宜。I found out that the things here are cheaper. 我发现这里的东西更便宜。Literally, I discovered here's stuff more cheap. 我发现这里的东西更便宜。Only characters. 我发现这里的东西更便宜。Faster. 我发现这里的东西更便宜。下一个，方便。方便 means convenient. 比如说，现在网上买东西很方便。It's very convenient to shop online now. 现在网上买东西很方便。Later order, now, online, shopping, very convenient. 现在网上买东西很方便。Right, only characters.现在网上买东西很方便。Faster, 现在网上买东西很方便。下一个，放。放 ,it means to put, to place. 比如说，你把我的衬衫放哪儿了？ Where did you put my shirt?你把我的衬衫放哪儿了? The letter order, you 把 my shirt put where? 你把我的衬衫放哪儿了? Only characters, 你把我的衬衫放哪儿了? Faster,你把我的衬衫放哪儿了？下一个，放心，放心。To ease one's mind, to not worried. 比如说，你放心吧，我没事。Don't worry, I'm all right. 你放心吧，我没事。Okay, now only characters. 你放心吧，我没事。Faster, 你放心吧，我没事。下一个，分。分 It's a unit of money. It's 1% of 1块. 比如说，一分钱，一分货。You get what you pay for. 一分钱，一分货。So, 一分钱 is a cent of money, and 一分货 a cent of product. 一分钱，一分货。Okay, without 拼音，一分钱，一分货。Faster, 一分钱，一分货。Okay, and 分 have another meaning. It's distinguish. 比如说，我分不出来谁是哥哥，谁是弟弟。I can't distinguish who is the elder brother and who is the younger brother. 我分不出来谁是哥哥，谁是弟弟。Okay, let's read one more time. 我分不出来谁是哥哥，谁是弟弟。Only characters. 我分不出来谁是哥哥，谁是弟弟。Faster. 我分不出来谁是哥哥，谁是弟弟。Okay, 下一个， 附近，附近。It means nearby. 比如说，我家附近一个商店也没有。There isn't any store near my home. 我家附近一个商店也没有。Literally, my home's nearby. One store, not half. 我家附近一个商店也没有。Now only characters. 我家附近一个商店也没有。Faster. 我家附近一个商店也没有。干净，干净。Clean. 比如说，请你三点前把房间打扫干净。Please clean the room by 3 o'clock. 请你三点前把房间打扫干净。Let's read one more time. 请你三点前把房间打扫干净。Only characters. 请你三点前把房间打扫干净。Faster. 请你三点前把房间打扫干净。下一个，复习，复习。It means to review. 比如说，明天有汉语考试，我得好好复习。There's a Chinese exam tomorrow. I need to review well. 明天有汉语考试，我得好好复习。It's a little bit longer, so let's read one more time. 明天有汉语考试，我得好好复习。Alright, only characters. 明天有汉语考试，我得好好复习。Faster. 明天有汉语考试，我得好好复习。下一个，感兴趣，感兴趣。 It means to be interested. 比如说，我对这种电影不感兴趣。 I'm not interested in this kind of movie. 我对这种电影不感兴趣。So, 对 something 不感兴趣 is a structure to say not interested in something. 我对这种电影不感兴趣。Only characters. 我对这种电影不感兴趣。Right, faster.我对这种电影不感兴趣。下一个，感冒，感冒。 It means to catch a cold. 比如说，你穿的太少了，你不怕感冒吗？ You are wearing so few, aren't you afraid of catching a cold? 你穿的太少了，你不怕感冒吗？ One more time. 你穿的太少了，你不怕感冒吗？ Okay, now only characters. 你穿的太少了，你不怕感冒吗？ Faster. 你穿的太少了，你不怕感冒吗？下一个，个子，个子。 It means height or stature. 比如说，你和 Mike 谁个子高？ Who is taller, you or Mike? 你和 Mike 谁个子高？ Only characters. 你和 Mike 谁个子高？ Faster. 你和 Mike 谁个子高？下一个，刚才，刚才 ，it means just now。比如说，我刚才在电视上看到一条新闻。I saw a piece of news on TV just now。我刚才在电视上看到一条新闻。Literally, I just now on the TV saw a piece of news. 我刚才在电视上看到一条新闻。Only characters. 我刚才在电视上看到一条新闻。下一个。跟，跟 ，it means with。比如说，你昨天跟谁去看电影了？Who did you go to the cinema with yesterday? 你昨天跟谁去看电影了 ？Literally, you yesterday with whom go see movie?你昨天跟谁去看电影了 ？All right, only characters. 你昨天跟谁去看电影了 ？Faster. 你昨天跟谁去看电影了？下一个，根据，根据 ，it means according to or based on. 比如说。每个人要根据自己的情况选择。Everyone has to make a choice according to his own situation. 每个人要根据自己的情况选择。One more time. 每个人要根据自己的情况选择。Only characters. 每个人要根据自己的情况选择。Faster. 每个人要根据自己的情况选择。下一个，公斤。公斤 means kilogram. 比如说，我胖了两公斤。I've put on 2 kilos. 我胖了两公斤。All right, without 拼音，我胖了两公斤。Faster, 我胖了两公斤。下一个，更，更 ，it means more or even more.比如说，我希望我的汉语明年会更好。I hope my Chinese will be better next year. 我希望我的汉语明年会更好。Right? One more time. 我希望我的汉语明年会更好。Only characters. 我希望我的汉语明年会更好。Okay, faster. 我希望我的汉语明年会更好。
Jumping off the edge, they say dream is never done.